this video, you're about to discover how to correct perspective mistakes in your photos. So this technique is extremely powerful and it allows you to create perfect, flawless geometry in photos where you do not have that type of geometry. For example, we'll be working with this original unedited photo, and this photo was shot at the Holocaust Memorial in Berlin. Now, what's interesting about this photo is that we have these massive vertical structures on both sides of the subject, and there's great potential to create a really dramatic photo. But the problem we have is that the geometry just does not look right. All the lines tend to converge towards the top of the image, which essentially means that none of the lines are straight. But a human eye doesn't really like that, and this photo would look a lot more pleasing if all the lines were actually straight. And by the end of this video, we'll have taken this original unedited photo and converted it into this beautiful final product where all the lines are perfectly straight, they're parallel to each other, we have perfect geometry, and this type of geometry looks really pleasing to the human eye. So let me pick up the Snapseed app and let me show you how you can create this type of geometry in your photos. So in order to fix the perspective problems in this photo, I'm going to start by tapping on Tools at the bottom, and I'll select the Perspective module on the second row. So in the Perspective module, by default, all these options will come up, and you can choose between Tilt, Rotate, Scale, and Free. So let me quickly walk you through these options to show you what each of them does. So the Tilt option, which is probably the most useful option, allows you to essentially adjust or tilt the perspective of your photos. And if you swipe your finger horizontally across the screen, you can adjust the horizontal perspective like so, or if you swipe your finger vertically, you can change the vertical perspective. So if you swipe to one side horizontally, what you're doing is essentially you're telling the camera to change the perspective in the same way that it would change it if you actually took a step to one side physically. Or if we go all the way to the other side, we are literally making the same changes that would happen to the photo if we were stepping all the way to the right. So to make this photo great, ideally, I'd be standing right in between these tall pillars, right in the center, and that creates beautiful symmetry. But if I wasn't standing in the center, and I am, actually, but if I wasn't, then by using the horizontal slider, I could change that perspective. And the same thing happens vertically. If I go in one direction, I can essentially make the same changes that the camera would make if I managed to somehow capture this shot from a higher vantage point. Or if I go in the other direction, I am essentially making the equivalent changes that would happen if I got lower at the time of taking the shot. So the perspective tool in many ways allows you to fix the mistakes you made while taking the photo, or if the iPhone camera just created a perspective issue for some reason, then you can fix them with the tilt as well. So the rotate you already know, and it just rotates the photo, so that's pretty easy. Then there's the scale option, and if you swipe your finger vertically, you can compress or stretch the photo vertically, or if you go horizontally, you can do the same thing, except this time it's horizontal. And finally, the freeform option allows you to take any of the corners and drag them wherever you want to drag them, but I doubt you'll be using this option because it doesn't give you that much control, to tell you the truth. So now I've messed up this photo so much that I kind of have to start over. So I'm just gonna cancel everything I've done by tapping on the bottom left. And now we're back with the photo we started with. So I'm gonna open perspective again, and this time I'll try to do it correctly. And the first thing I'm gonna work with is the rotate tool right here. And with the rotate tool, my goal is to rotate the photo just a little bit so that it's roughly straight. And obviously there are no straight vertical lines in this, so I can't really get it perfect. But if I just do an initial adjustment and rotate, it'll be easier to do the second step in tilt. So now I'm gonna select tilt. And in tilt, I'm not worried about horizontal perspective at all, because it was accurate at the very beginning. But the vertical perspective has some problems. In particular, all the lines, they tend to converge at the top. Or in other words, if you look at these vertical lines, they all go to the center of the photo, like so. And I want to make them perfectly straight, because that will look so much better to the human eye. So to do that, I need to swipe down, and I need to do this for quite a bit. until I get to a perspective that looks good to me. Now, there are a lot of vertical lines in this photo, so you cannot have them all be perfectly vertical. So you have to pick the most prominent lines in this specific photo that you want to optimize for. And the two lines that I'm really interested in are the lines in the foreground. So I'm talking about this vertical line here on the left and these vertical lines here on the right. Of course, there are many other vertical lines in this photo, but I'll just pick the ones in the foreground and I'll try to make sure that those are perfectly straight. So now I'll return to the rotate module, and in rotate, I'm just gonna attempt to rotate the image a little bit so that everything is 100% vertical. And now that I've made this change, I will go back to tilt again and I'll tweak the image just a little bit more, and probably I'll never have it 100% perfect, but the closer I can get to perfection, the better. So I'll keep moving between the tilt and the rotate options to create a photo that's as straight as possible, but obviously I have to call it a day at some point, so I'm not gonna keep doing this forever. I'll just do it one last time. I think I'm good as far as tilt goes. So now I'll touch rotate for the last time. And I think here we're good too. So if we do a quick before and after, then this is the photo we started with. And as I release my finger, this is what we have in the end. Now, this looks so much better, but there's one unnecessary change we've introduced in the process, and that relates to the human subject. So if we look at the original photo, you'll see that the human figure is of average height, but as I release my finger, the after version has essentially made this person shorter. And that's an unintended consequence of the edits we've done. But fortunately, I can correct that quite easily if I tap on the perspective at the bottom, and if I now select scale. So now, if I change the vertical scale like so, I can make the person a tiny bit taller again, but I don't want to overdo this. I just want the person to be of his natural height. And to make sure I get it right, I'm gonna compare it to the original, which looked like this. And now the final is pretty close to perfect, but I'm gonna make the man a tiny bit shorter now, actually. So something like this, I think is quite, actually no, I need to make him taller again. So sorry about that, but something like this feels quite accurate to me. So the man is roughly the same height as he was before we made the changes, and that's my goal. So now I'm really happy about what I've done, and I'm gonna go ahead and apply these changes by tapping on the OK check mark at bottom right. So now you'll see that we have the same photo, except the perspective looks so much better. And if you'd like to verify how vertical the lines really are, a little trick you can use is to zoom in with two fingers, and then you can compare these lines to the edge of the screen, like I'm doing it right now. So I'd say we're about 95% perfect. It's not 100% perfect, but to me 95% is good enough, because to get it exactly right, you'd probably have to spend hours and hours tweaking the photo, but I don't want to do it, at least not in this video. So now, the next step of this edit is to crop the image just a little bit. And to do that, I'm going to tap on Tools and open the Crop module. And the reason I want to crop this is because the distances on the left and the right-hand side of the photo aren't really equal at the moment. But for a photo like this, which really relies on symmetry, it's important that you actually get the symmetry exactly right. And that's why I'm here in the Crop module. So I'm going to select the original aspect ratio, which happens to be 4:3, and by the way, if you need to change the orientation of the photo, at the bottom you'll find this circular arrow, and if you tap there, you can switch between horizontal and vertical cropping. But obviously vertical is what we need for this photo, so I'm just gonna stick with original, which is 4:3 aspect ratio, and now I'm gonna crop in a little bit. And when cropping in, there are a few things I'd like to consider. Number one is I wanna make sure that the human figure is in the center of the photo horizontally. So I don't want the person to be too much to one side, because that doesn't look pretty. I'm aiming for symmetry here. Then, as a further note on symmetry, I'd like to make sure that the black bars, or the black margins on the left and on the right, are roughly of the same width. So that's another consideration. And finally, I'm happy to crop out some of the pixels at the bottom, Because to me, they don't necessarily add that much value. In fact, this photo becomes more dramatic if there aren't any extra pixels at the bottom, because then the human subject is positioned lower in the frame, and that way, this person stands out more against the huge vertical pillars on either side of him. So by cropping the photo like this, I can essentially make the photo more dramatic, and I can position the human subject low, which makes the pillars look taller. So now I'm gonna just do some final tweaks to make sure I get it exactly right. Again, I'm aiming for central subject placement, and I'm aiming for equal distance on the left and on the right. So let me just verify that I've been able to accomplish that. And this looks pretty good to me. And as a tip here, you can follow the vertical grid lines, and you can try to center these grid lines among the lines here on the right and on the left. And that's what I've done. And I think this should give me a very accurate result. So I'll apply changes. And now we've cropped the image, and I'm happy with the way it's cropped. But there's one small problem here at the top right. It's a tiny thing, but if you look at the top right-hand corner, and if we zoom in, you'll see it more, we have this problem area along the very edge of the photo. Ideally, it would be symmetrical, and this little triangle just wouldn't be there. But the good news is that we can fix it very easily using the healing tool. So let me open the healing tool. And now, all I want to do is just select this triangle on the right, which I don't like, and the healing tool did its job perfectly, and that problem area is now gone. While I'm here, I'll take a look at the photo to see if there's anything else I'd like to clean up. And in fact, there is, so I'll just clean up a few dots here. You don't really have to do this, but if you're in the cleaning tool, you might as well clean up everything. And yeah, I think that those were the only things that were worth cleaning up here. So now I'm gonna go ahead and apply the changes, and we've cleaned up the messy spot at the top right. So we're almost done now, but before we save our progress, I'd like to quickly go to Tune Image and do some final changes to the color. And the interesting thing about this photo is that it is very close to a monochrome photo, so there isn't that much color except here. So you'll see that there's some really warm tones in the central part of the frame, and that's because the evening light was shining on these structures. And I'd like to bring that out even more. And to do that, I'm gonna increase saturation. Now, I don't want to overdo this, because if I go too high, I'll start introducing some unnatural colors elsewhere in the photo. For example, this pillar at top left will become blue. So I can't go too high, but I can go quite a bit higher. And if I go to something like plus 30, I think that's quite an improvement. And now the warm light in the distant part of the photo stands out even more. So this is before saturation, this is after, and I like the after version better. Now, at the same time, I think I can further emphasize the light that's shining in the central part of the frame if I also bring the highlights up a little bit. So let me select highlights, and let me go up just a little bit. I don't want to go too high, because if I go too high, it will ruin other parts of the photo, so I can't go too high. But if I go to something like plus 20, that brings out these warm parts in the distance even more. And I think that's one of the coolest things about this photo, so I'm happy to increase the highlights a little bit. And finally, we're talking about warm light, then warmth is the perfect slider to adjust as well. And if we increase that just a little bit, you will see that the warm tones now stand out even more. But I don't want to do this too much. The risk that I have is that warmth affects the entire image, and if these tall pillars also start to become warm, then I'm losing some of the power of this photo, because these concrete pillars probably should not be perceived as warm and friendly. So it really can't go too high, but something like plus 5 will do the trick, because now these pillars are still cold, but you can see some hint of warm light in the background. And this looks good to me, so I'll do a quick before and after. So this is before Tune Image, this is after, and I like the after version better, so apply changes. And now, if we do an overall before and after, you'll see that this is the photo we started with, and you'll notice how all the lines have geometry issues. And as I release my finger, you'll see that now we have perfect geometry, much better color, and overall this photo just makes a much stronger visual impact. So I'm really happy we decided, and I'll go ahead and save our progress.